Well, hey everyone, I'm back with my Anna Mondays, and I decided to start my video with, well, a big one. And what do I mean by a big one? Well, I'm going to do one of the biggest anime debates that have probably been done to death, Full Metal Alchemist, the original series versus Brotherhood. Oh boy, this one is going to be a lot of fun to do, and I'm basically going to do things like the story, the animation, the villains, and the ending. That's how I'm going to compare these. Now, some villains, like the Homunculus, like Gluttony and Envy, I will not compare with each other, but the rest of them, I will. And I'm going to kind of mix it up between a couple of the Homunculus. Like, Wrath, I'm going to compare with Pride. I'll tell you why when I get to them. So let's get things started and let's start fighting. FMA 03 versus Brotherhood, let's hit it! Let's start out with the story. The story is the heart of where everything is, and let's hit it. Anyhow, we'll start out with basically both stories and compare the flow and how the story flows together and timing, pretty much. Starting off with the 03 and Brotherhood together, well, the story is they commit the ultimate taboo of trying to bring someone back from the dead, and they lose their body parts. While Edward loses an arm and a leg, his younger brother loses his entire body, and they try to go throughout the series to find the Philosopher's Stones to bring them back. Basically, that's it. It's just a few things are drawn out much more in 03. In fact, 03 has them trying to, well, enlist in the army and trying to serve in it and get everything situated. And let me tell you, it's long. There is some story plots they could have left out. A train robbery is basically what I'm talking about. And yeah, nothing really is huge here. It doesn't start hooking me in until after like the 7th episode, maybe the 8th episode, and we're given character and story arcs that, well, I really don't care about. Like, in fact, there is a character named Barry the Butcher who I really don't give a shit about, but they decided to give us his backstory of how he got his body taken from him in that suit of armor. Well, then Brotherhood is just implied. That kind of gets on my nerves. But then there's Brotherhood's pacing, where it shows them already in the army with a filler episode, and yeah, it just doesn't work as well as you think it should. Basically, it's whatever floats your boat. I mean, technically you could watch like the first 15 episodes of the first season on the 03 series and then jump over to Brotherhood. But honestly, the first half of the story in the original 03 series just feels like a lot of filler. A lot of talking and exposition going on, while Brotherhood gets straight to the point until things are just drawn out completely. You know, it feels like that you've skipped a whole bunch. So it feels like Brotherhood isn't exactly a reboot, but you feel like you have to watch both to get what they're coming from, or at least read the manga. Me, on the other hand, I'm just not sure. I mean, I don't know which one that I like more, which one that I want more, but I like the flow of Brotherhood's story better. It's much more radical, and it gets way to the point right when you need it to be, and it throws you into the action. Instead of showing Edward and Alphonse arguing in the very first episode, which is just boring as hell, showing them enlisting in the army, showing them fighting in the army, and doing all these stupid tests, while Brotherhood just gets right to it. In fact, I'm on part of the team that thinks you don't have to watch 03 to get it. But don't get too angry with me here. I'm not criticizing 03 for slow storytelling. I'm just criticizing it for just kind of not picking up the pace. Brotherhood picks up the pace a little too much, but I don't know. And then there's the halfway point when we get to the stories. At the halfway point, Both of the stories seem to go at the same spot, and then they seem to take completely different crossroads. O3 story goes kind of bananas with different homunculus backstories, and you don't even know what the fuck's going on anymore. You're seeing them go from town to town, and it's like, what the hell? What does this have to do with anything in the Philosopher's Stone? But it does kind of match up nicely. While Brotherhood follows the more manga route and tries to go the manga's way, and it's basically a straight line where they meet several different characters and we're introduced to some characters that are killed off quickly, then there is the sin of, well, Shao Tucker, which everyone hates, including me, and I've even had his voice actor Chuck Huber on the show. Brotherhood did the smart thing of killing off Shao Tucker right in his second introduction episode, so power to ya. However, his story in the O3 version is he's trying to get his daughter's body back to normal after he turned her into a dog, and it just goes really weird from then on out. And yet you see Shao Tucker through the entire anime, and you still hate his guts for what he's done. Yeah, basically it's that. You're getting all these twists, turns, and emotions in the O3 version, and it can be straight up confusing when you watch it. While Brotherhood, it just flat out tells you. Plus, I like Scar's story arc in this. And now, I'm gonna go to the animation. I'm gonna say, though, the winner of this story has to go to Brotherhood. And I'm sorry for O3 fans, I just like Brotherhood's faster pacing story a lot better. So the winner is Brotherhood in this round. Let's move on to the animation. Now we're on to animation, and before anyone asks, I'm not going to judge any of the music, because the music is nearly relatively the same, but the animation. Is it fair to judge animation when there's a 7-year gap between the series? Well, in a way, it is, and I think I'm going to do something a little different this round. Alright, the 2003 series has some beautiful animation for its time. Especially for early 2000s anime and the budget that it was used, its animation at points is so flowing and beautiful that you can't really honestly believe what you're looking at. I look at it and I don't think that I'm watching an anime that is from 03 at all. I look at it and it feels like I'm watching one that could have been done in 2012 or 2013. Yeah, that is about fucking Fate Zero anime style for its time, and I don't say that it's better than Fate Zero. It's very hard to compare to Fate Zero or Unlimited Blade Works type of animation, but for its time, the 03 looks beautiful. But then we get the updated animation of Brotherhood that they did from the ground up, and it's beautiful too. But here's the thing. The Brotherhood animation actually is really good, very flowing, and very natural feeling, and I will say, it is a golden gem animation. I mean, I love the animation, but this came out in 2010 or 2009, one of the two, and you've got to look at it from this point of view. At this time, they had the money and the budget to actually get better animation and update it to be a lot better than the 03 series. They finally was able to make it look very flowing and very vibrant. That's all I'm going to say. But look at the 2003 series and look at it very closely. Look how gracious that they flow. It's not better than the 2010, not by a long shot, but they actually had the money to tune this anime up in the 2010 Brotherhood version. And as crazy as it's going to sound, because of the time period restraints, I'm going to go with the 2003 version's animation. Now, before everyone starts leaving shit comments all over my YouTube saying that I lack taste in animation, I know that Brotherhood's animation looks better. I know it's fantastic. I know it's beautiful. But 03 barely had anything to work off of, and look what they gave us. And look at some of their openings, too. Now, I'm not going to do openings in this, because that's not right. But, yeah. They had literally barely anything but a half-finished manga to work off of, and the second half of the anime itself doesn't follow anything really from the manga. It follows more of what they came up with, and what they came up with looks exceptionally beautiful. Luckily, Brotherhood had the manga, and they could do the vibration and the anime and everything flowing the way that they wanted it to originally, and how the source material is supposed to look. But this, the 2003 version, did it on its own merits, and that is fucking commendable right there. All alone, you look at this and you don't think, this came out in 03? Hell, this came out in 03? Look at it! It's fucking beautiful! So, just because of time period alone and them not having the money to actually give the budget that the series deserved, I'm giving the point to the 03 series. Now, I'm not going to go straight on to the characters from here. I'm going to go straight on to the villains, because the main good guys really don't change all that much. So I'm going to do a comparison to the Homunculus. Let's move on. Well, now we're going to start off with Lust. Now, before anyone says anything, the other characters I'm not going to compare is going to be the two Envies and the two Gluttonies. They are taken off the list because, well, they really don't change much of their personality at all. They're the same. Gluttony is fat, and he likes to eat, and that's it. While Envy is an asshole, but there's a little twist to him being an asshole, and that's it. Okay, let's look at the villains, like Lust, like I was saying. Lust, in this one, is much more sympathetic in the 03 version. She definitely has a story arc, while in the Brotherhood version, she's just evil. Like, she is a follower of Father, that's it, she's evil. There really isn't much polish on her character or her motivation, but I think that's what the Homunculus are supposed to be. Mindless, brainless servants. But still, I've got to say that 03 Lust is a lot more likable. And like I said, they didn't have anything to go off of after they got to the middle of the freaking anime. And they did things with her character that a lot of people like. I really like what they did with Lust. I like her relationship with Scar and Scar's brother. I think it's fantastic. I almost like Lust 03 way better than Brotherhood for sure. Now, I'm not going to stop and point it out and say this is it, but there is a point going for the 03 when it comes to the villains in this section. I've got to say, Lust was really fleshed out way better here, and she's highly more relatable. Wallace, in the Brotherhood version, she's more just there and making evil speeches, and that's it. She gets a very brutal death scene by Roy Mustang, but other than that, that's about it for Lust. There is really not that much to her in Brotherhood, so I like 03 Lust a lot more. Let's move on to another character. Let's go to Sloth. Now we're on to Sloth, and this is going to be an easy one for me, because I knew it was going to be easy right when I started. Sloth 03 versus Sloth Brotherhood. Sloth 03 is actually Trisha Elric, is her destructed body that was brought back by Ed and Al. And now she's a Homunculus that fights on the side. That was actually really good writing and something I didn't expect. It kind of blew my mind a little bit. Now we scoot over to Sloth and Brotherhood, who is a guy who just can't die, and that has to dig a hole through the entire episodes that he's in, who gets his ass handed to him by Major Armstrong and General Armstrong, and that's about it. Basically, this is an easy one, and it is probably the easiest one for me. I'm gonna honestly go with the 03 version. She's not just a character with a catchphrase that says, "What a pain, what a pain, I just want to sleep." No, she is a character with a lot of death put into her, and that's what makes her work a lot better than, say, the Brotherhood version. Though I will say the Brotherhood version does get in a good fight every now and then, but still, it's just not the same to me. All I've got to say is, well, it was easily an 03 pick here. I thought this was genius writing here, because honestly, I like the fact that her body was used again and they make a reference to it. In fact, that was really well done in the 03 Homunculus versions. Now, this one was rather quick, I know, but I'm going to move onward to Greed, who honestly is going to be an easier pick again. Now we're on to Greed, who basically in the 03 version, he is Dante's ex-lover, while in the 2010 Brotherhood version, he is basically the same character we're introduced to in 03, but he also gets a bunch of differences added to him once he forms with Ling, and they become Lingreed, and his story is fleshed out even more, and he's more than just a character that wants everything, that's an avarice character that, you know, reaches out for everything but power. There's a lot more polish on Greed in the Brotherhood version. Though I will say, I do like first Greed's design better, and I like 03 Greed's design. But this Greed in the 03 version feels like complete and utter waste of time and filler. It feels like he doesn't belong here, and it's really fucking sad. While, I've gotta say, the 2010 Brotherhood Greed, he was a good fit. At first, I thought they were going to go down that same route. He was just there to die, but no. He's there, he joins up with Ling, they join bodies together, and he becomes a semi-good guy for the run of the rest of the show. His character is so much more polished than the 03 version. And honestly, I wouldn't like him any other way. He's actually my third favorite character out of the Brotherhood run of Fullmetal Alchemist. The 03 version just feels like he's there, and he gets thrown away. He does get a cool fight, though, and it is really a nice animation-style fight. But as character development goes, yeah, the Brotherhood Greed is gonna win this round. And that's pretty much all I've gotta say. I mean, I know people are expecting me to really just throw it out there and say, hey, the Brotherhood Greed is blah blah blah, I like the original, but no, this original Greed really didn't do much for me. While the Brotherhood is a perfect choice. I mean, his character development just worked so freaking well, and he got a lot of polish added to him. I can handle Lust and Sloth getting the shit pushed to the back, or getting the character's development axed to the grinder or whatever, because I really like this version of Greed. He's just so much more polished, so much more interesting, and the dynamic he has with Ling Yao is perfection. That's all I'm gonna say, it's perfection. Anyhow, let's go to the next villain. And this time, I'm gonna be comparing, well, two different Homunculuses. One Wrath, one Pride, you'll see. Now, the reason I'm comparing these two together, Wrath and Pride, is simple. They're both the evil little kids of the group. Now, it just depends how one is used for that grouping. Well, let's look at Wrath before I go to Pride. Wrath is a crybaby. Basically, he is the baby that their teacher Izumi had, and he is a fucking crybaby. Ugh, God, I hate this character. He's annoying. He's a little shit stain. I can't stand this little brat. Oh, God. Every time he's on screen, I fucking cringe. And I know that they were trying to do something interesting with his development, like having a piece of Edward's body onto him, but still, God, he's terrible. He is one of the most annoying characters, and I guess it's the voice that bothers me. I don't know. Fucking Crybaby Wrath just annoys the fucking shit out of me. The only scene I like with him is when Izumi storms the soldier gate to take him away and kill him herself, because I want her to kill him. I want this little bastard to die a brutal, horrible death because he's fucking annoying. Now, let's scoot on over to Pride now. Pride is fucking terrifying. All I've got to say, this was the way to make an evil little kid. Pride is horrifyingly evil. I mean, the fact that he just shows up as this sweet, innocent little kid named Celine Bradley is kind of an offsetting thing, because you really wouldn't judge this kid. He looks like a happy little kid. And I've got to say, Brittany Karbowski's vocal performance was excellent here. How she was able to switch the voice from being a cutesy kid to being pure evil was amazing, especially when he changes. They use him perfectly. They don't make him a crybaby or a little brat. No, they make him just flat out pure evil, and he works so much well. Now, you're gonna know why I didn't compare the two Prides together. Well, this is why. There's two different King Bradleys, basically. Let's go on to King Bradley, my favorite villain of the group. We have the O3 King Bradley and the Brotherhood King Bradley. While the O3 King Bradley is there, I don't have very much nice things to say about this King Bradley. Why the fuck is he a robot? Seriously, why? What is the point of him being a fucking robot here? I don't understand it, because his ultimate, I just didn't get that. And plus, O3 Bradley isn't intimidating like Brotherhood Bradley, and I'll get to that in a second. O3 Bradley is a dick. Like, when Izumi is storming the castle gates and he just shows up and he just does his little evil laugh and like, oh, well, I'll have to do something about that. Nah, it does not work at all. Because the only fight you really see him do is his fight with Roy Mustang, and that's basically it. Then, yeah, we're revealed that he's a robot. Oh, good God almighty. A fucking robot. How lame do you have to be to make a fucking robot out of this? Comparing him to Brotherhood Bradley. Fucking awesome. Brotherhood Bradley is the thief of the show. And why do I call him a thief? Because he steals the whole show as the villain. And what's the sad thing about Brotherhood Bradley? He's somebody's bitch in this anime. But I would love to see Father or whoever go against him. He has a tragic backstory. He has nothing but pain and misery. Yet, he's able to use that and fight and kick ass. Yet, mocking the religion of characters like Scar and etc. Even in death, he mocks them. He doesn't really give a shit. The dude shows up from being assumed dead and then takes out a fucking tank in a few seconds. Plus, they use him very well. They keep him in the shadows at first, like when he shows up to fight Greed, and he murders Greed right away. He is easily the crown jewel of Brotherhood, and he is worthy of being the king, labeled the king in this version. He is just a complete and utter badass in this. I love his character. He is even made it, if you recall my top 13 favorite anime villain list, he made it to number 3. He made it to my top fucking 3 villains of favorite anime villains of all. What does that tell you? Now, I'm going to scoot over to the final villains, the big bad. We gotten Bradley. We've talked about Bradley. Let's talk about the two final big bads of Full Metal Alchemist. Here we are, the two final big bads. Dante and Father. And Dante and Father are very, very similar characters, but it just depends how you look at them. Dante is a body snatcher who has lived for thousands of years and used to be married and in love with the father of the original series, Hohenheim. Yet, they leave each other, they lose a child together, and then she breaks the taboo law of bringing that child back, which makes it to be Envy. Now she's trying to get the body of Edward Elric, or trying to have a kid with Edward Elric, they really don't clarify, by trying to take Rose's body. It's very interesting to see her obsession with Hohenheim, that she never really got over him, and the fact that she could just live through thousands of years by taking bodies of other people. I like how they disguise her as an old lady, and pretty much she's really well written. She's a very interesting villain, but there are just some flaws to her character that I don't like. They make her too powerful, for one. Two, her story really never gets completely finished. You never get to see this ultimate final battle in the 03 version, and no, I'm not gonna talk about the shitty-ass movie because I don't want to. Now let's talk about Father. Father is actually very intimidating. Sitting in the basement of the castle, he sits there and brings out the homunculus. He's the one that created them from the 7 deadly sin portions of his own body. He craved to be human, yet he was envious of all humans. He hated them all. He wanted to exterminate them all like cockroaches and be able to create the ultimate Philosopher's Stone to become a god. Both of these characters have a very big god complex, and they're both connected really well with Hohenheim. Though, I will say, I think I like Father's connection to Hohenheim just a little more. Dante isn't somebody that I hate or anything like that, I just hate portions of her character. Father, I'm not a huge fan of, but his connection to Hohenheim is a lot more interesting than Dante's. Mainly because, well, he used Hohenheim's form to create himself and to create that form. He resembles Hohenheim, and he's using Hohenheim's power on top of all of that. So, this is more of a very personal battle with him. It's something that he blames himself for, because he let the little homunculus out of the flask. And it's basically all his fault. So, which one do I like better? Well, I'm gonna have to lean more towards Father in this one. Now, let's go to my chart and see which round of the villains wins in this one. Okay, let's see it. Well, obviously from the 03 version, only 2 characters won in this battle. And then in the Brotherhood version, 4 won. So, I'm gonna have to say it, the winner of this round is actually Brotherhood again. Now let's move on to the endings, which everyone has probably been waiting for me to talk to. Now we're on to the controversial piece of this video, the ending. Which ending do I like better? You know, I have heard so many people say that the 03's ending is the best, and I've heard so many people say Brotherhood's ending is the best. For me, well, let's look at what we got. Basically in 03, Edward, for some reason, is sent back in time to London so he can save his brother's body, and somehow that ends up being an alternate world of World War II! And that's it. There's no big finish, and there's no final ending, and Alphonse remembers absolutely nothing. He just knows Edward is missing, and the story is completely and utterly unresolved. The fight with Envy, it just ends on a giant cliffhanger, and it's a dark cliffhanger on top of all that, and the only way to get the full-fledged ending is unfortunately to watch that shitty-ass movie that came out, and that movie is garbage. Sorry. I don't like this ending very much. Then there's the Brotherhood ending where everyone is happy. The brothers get their body back and everybody is happy. It ends on a happy note. Winry and Ed get married or want to get married. Everybody's happy. Everybody's got the bodies, everything, and there's all sorts of sunshine, happy shit going on. Well, either one of these, it's very hard to pick an ending to end to a series that is as epic as both versions of Full Metal Alchemist. You could go with the dark cliffhanger ending where you have to put it together yourself, kind of like a Sopranos ending. Or you could go with the happy ending where everybody is happy, including Hohenheim and etc. For me, and I know this is going to sound extremely cliche, campy, and everything else, I'm going to go, in this case, with the Brotherhood ending. The Brotherhood ending wrapped up the story. It did leave a lot of things on a darker set, but not completely dark. Everyone has a happy ending, of sorts. And honestly, it kind of just works out. To me, I think the ending to Brotherhood is an excellent ending. And I think the O3 ending gets a bad reputation once in a while. I like both of these, but honestly, and if I had to push the hardest, I'm going to go with the original Brotherhood ending. Because Brotherhood, honestly, was a fantastic adventure all the way around. And that basically is it for this. It's just a better ending. You finally get to set out what you needed to see, and it's the end of a very long, wonderful adventure. And honestly, that's my pick for this video. So that about does it for now. I finally finished comparing the Full Metal Alchemist series of this anime showdown. And I haven't done one of these since my Dragon Ball GT vs. Dragon Ball Super video. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this one. I know I did. It was a lot of fun to do and compare the series again. And it made me want to actually go and rewatch it all again. Anyway, if there's any more anime showdowns you'd like me to do, a reboot versus a reboot, or an original, or a sequel versus a sequel, tell me in the comments. Always remember, I am listening.
I have a very important question. Did you like what you saw? I'm betting you did. And if you did, you should like and subscribe to Mr. Tim's YouTube. Lots of awesome reviews, lists, interviews. And if you haven't subscribed yet, you're missing out. Always remember, he's listening.